Good morning everyone. Today we'll start with the chapter the cell. So first of all, what is a cell? Cells are the building blocks of a body or an organism. So these cells, they act like bricks of a building. So all the organisms, even if we consider our own body, they are made up of cells. So the main function of the cells, what is the main function? They carry out all the basic functions of the life, like growth, metabolism and reproduction. So when an organism grows, there is a growth of cells which is taking place, the metabolism, the digestion in the body, if you consider human body. So all these are taking place with the help of cells. Now, who discovered cell? The cells were discovered by Robert Hooke. So Robert Hooke noticed the cells of a cork under a microscope, because they are very minute, they are very small, which cannot be seen with the naked eye. So the cells were seen through a microscope, and later on a detailed structure of the cell and its functions of various parts were discovered when electron microscope was discovered. So with the invention of the electron microscope, because it helps to view the cells very minutely. Now, the concept that all the living beings, they are made up of cells, it was explained by cell theory. And this cell theory, which is there, it is given by Sheldon and Schwann. And this is an important question from the exam point of view. It is asked that who proposed the cell theory. And there are two main postulates of the theory. This theory states that the cells are the structural and functional units of living organisms. That means that all the organisms, they are made up of cells. The structure of the organism, it is made up of cells, and these cells are carrying out all the functions of the body, whether it is digestion, whether it is growth, all these functions, they are carried out by the cells. And the next postulate is that the new cells arise by the division of pre-existing cells. So what does this mean? This means that the pre-existing cells are present. These pre-existing cells, which are already present, they will give rise to new cells. Like in case of our body, the skin is shed off. Human body, every day the skin cells are being shed off, and then new cells arise in the place of those cells. So they arise from the pre-existing cells only. The cells which are already present, they will give rise to the new cells. Now, on the basis of the number of cells, the organisms, they are classified into two categories. One is unicellular and the other is multicellular. Unicellular means the organisms, they are formed by a single cell only. Only a single cell is present. Whereas multicellular means that many cells together form an organism. As in case of bacteria, it is a unicellular organism. Amoeba, yeast, these all are unicellular organisms. Chelmydomonas, they are formed of single cell. And multicellular organisms like rose plant, frog, crocodile, humans, they all are made up of many cells. So they are come under the category of multicellular organisms. Next, if you'll see that these cells, when they come together, a group of cells, they form tissues. Then a group of tissues, they form organs, and different organs come together and form the organ system. And different organ systems, when they come together, they form an organism. If you consider human body, now in case of human body, you will see that we have different cells which will form, if you consider nervous system, they will form tissues. Nerve cells, nervous tissues will be formed. And these tissues, then they will form different organs. Then those different organs will form the organ system, like the nervous system. Then different circulatory system, digestive system, they all will come together, and then they will form a whole organism. then on the basis of the shapes of the cells, there are different shapes of the cells which are present. So according to the different shapes of the cells are related to the specific functions. Like we have amoeba, which is irregular in shape. You have guard cells present, which are also which are present in the leaves. They are bean shaped cells. You have seen a nerve cell, so it helps in the conduction of the nerve impulses. Then we have different type of blood cells present. So there are present in different shapes. Cells, they occur in the different sizes also. They vary greatly in the size. The smallest cell which is present, that can be of from 0.1 to 0.15 micron, which is in the case of bacteria. If we consider human body, the smallest cell are the blood cells. Then the longest cells are the nerve cells, because they transmit nerve impulses throughout the body, so they are the longest in the body. Then if we consider the egg of an ostrich, it is 15 to 20 centimeter in diameter, and it is considered to be the largest cell. Clear? Next is cell division. What is cell division? The new cells, they are formed by cell division in all living organisms. Now, why do we need new cells? Because these new cells which are formed, they help in the growth of the body. So when the body is growing, for the growth of that body, we need new cells, and these new cells will be formed by the division, the cell division. When the cells, they divide, they give rise to new cells. Then we need new cells to repair the wounded tissues. Like sometimes if we have a cut on our hand, so wound is there. So those wounds which are present, to repair those wounds, we need new cells. Then the cells in our body, when they get worn out, they get old, they die. So to replace those old and the worn out cells, cell division is required. We need new cells for replacing the old and the worn out cells, because the cells will have a specific lifespan. After that, they worn out, they become old, and to replace them, we need the new cells.